Back here with Mr. Chris Mannix. LeBron James made a rare appearance at the Lakers facility on Monday when the team announced Frank Vogel as their new head coach. Don't get used to that LeBron signing, though. Despite rumors about how prominent his role will be in recruiting a free agent, we're now hearing LeBron is expected to stay in the background to avoid the perception that he is running the Lakers. Mannix, how involved does LeBron need to be this summer if they want any chance at landing someone big?
I think he needs to be intimately involved in every step of the free agent process. I mean, being involved in free agent recruiting is a lot different than being involved in the coaching search or in other personnel matters like style of play.
It's accepted.
It's accepted and encouraged. I mean, you know, you guys talked about this earlier in the show. The reason Kevin Durant went to Golden State is because the guys came out to recruit him out in the Hamptons. James Harden, you know, the former MVP, has sat in on meetings to recruit guys. Sat in, you know, when LaMarcus Aldridge was being recruited by multiple teams, you know, stars from those teams were sitting in on those meetings.
And Harden was a huge part of Chris Paul agreeing to come to Houston.
Absolutely. Like, this is part of your responsibility. If you want to win, you've got to go out there and sell guys that have good choices on making one that sides with you. But even more important for LeBron as this month's move forward, he and the Lakers have to present a unified front. Right now, we look at the Lakers, and because Magic Johnson peeled back the curtain in the way that he did, we look at them as being dysfunctional, in a state of disrepair. Like, I thought it was a mistake for LeBron to be at that Frank Vogel press conference and not speak to the media a little bit. I think he needs to kill the perception, and it's widely believed that Jason Kidd is his guy, he's got the relationship with him, and that Frank Vogel is little more than a placeholder. That he could go, I think he could go a long way towards putting a lot of that in the back burner for now by publicly addressing some of that stuff.
Okay, so some of this, though, LeBron's damned if you do, damned if he doesn't. Because LeBron is stayed out of the coaching search to a degree that Ty Lue doesn't get the job. And now, but he was involved. So he wasn't involved enough or had a big enough hand to where they actually end up following through and hiring Ty Lue. But he was involved enough to where Jason Kidd gets the job. Jason Kidd got that job because the people within the Lakers wanted to potentially initially give Jason Kidd the head coaching job. And they were cowed by the public reaction. So then they wanted Jason Kidd on the staff. LeBron said during the season, and he was criticized for it during the season when it came to Anthony Davis, I'm always recruiting. Remember, he said to Tanya Ganguly, ask me if I want to play with Kevin Durant. Yeah, I do. Ask me if I want to play. And he said, I know the rules. The rules can't, I'm not breaking the rules and nobody can control me. If it's true that he is now removing himself from it, and I don't know if it's true or not, it's because he's been asked to. It's because it goes totally against the way he has been his entire career when it comes to trying to get players to play with him and what he said he was doing just months ago. So it is, yes, of course the Lakers, the only chance they have at a major free agent is LeBron being involved. The only reason he wouldn't be involved is if the Lakers front office tells him not to be involved, and that would be a major mistake. Even for a team that's made a bunch of mistakes, that would be a shocking mistake.
I'm not arguing that LeBron, you know, that Jason Kidd is LeBron's guy. I'm not saying that's true. I'm just saying that LeBron was at the Frank Vogel press conference. He could sit there and just say things about Frank Vogel. He has experience against Frank Vogel. He hasn't worked with him or coached with him, but in the playoffs for 3 years against the Indiana Pacers, LeBron James played against him, played against Frank Vogel teams. Talk a little bit about that. I mean, just try to kill this outside perception that this is a David Blatt 2.0 situation, that your guy is eventually going to take over. I'm not sitting here and saying that it's true. I don't know that any of that is true, but publicly that's how it's perceived. And LeBron being there, he could have done some more, I thought, on that day.
If LeBron's not involved in free agency, because we are, I don't think they have any shot at the top free agent, that being Kevin Durant. I think they have very little shot at the second free agent or number 1A, 1AB, in Kawhi. Very little chance. So now, let's look at the real possibilities who they have. And to not have LeBron James in that process, man, I don't trust anyone in the Lakers organization. And right now, they're doing everything the wrong way. Yes, the press conference, LeBron could have level set some things. He could have said some things, but he is damned if he do, he is damned if he don't. Because Magic quitting and revealing some of the stuff that happened, that didn't help. the organization. You think the other free agents right now are looking at the Lakers being like, yeah, this is the next great dynasty come? No.
No, it's a fractured organization with problems and leaks and no real hierarchy.
And we forget about the West is still stacked. There's still a lot of teams in the West they have to be able to go through. And players are looking at what's the best option for their future. LeBron James, if he's not involved in the recruiting, I don't know what type of recruiting tool that they have. Who do you have as your lead person talking to free agents? Rob Pelinka? That's it? Kurt Rambis? Really? What about the owner? No, like you don't want to talk to those people. You need LeBron James, and as my man Goodwin said, put the trophies in the room and LeBron and let them talk, Vince, and let them work it out.
Vince Goodwill was on the show earlier this week. One note on the Vogel press conference, back to the free agency stuff. You and I both well know that since that took place 2 hours after Magic Johnson dropped bombs, unless LeBron was going to say, I have a statement to make and I will not be taking any questions, all of the questions were not going to be, how did Frank Vogel and Roy Hibbert scheme against those 2013 Miami Heat teams? They would have been, what about Magic? What about Magic? Why didn't he talk to you? What are your...
And LeBron's so, skilled. LeBron can make
what,
up stuff.
That's what I'm saying. Like, LeBron's not... This isn't his first rodeo.
Okay,
like,
but so now we're simultaneously... So I just want to... LeBron had too big of a hand in this, but now he's not having a big enough hand in that. He showed up to the press conference, but he should have done more at the press conference. Like, what we know is this. The only shot they have at Kyrie Irving is if LeBron is the one convincing him to come. That's the next name on your list, right? If we assume Klay's not a real available free agent.
Yes.
KD, Kawhi, Kyrie. Is Jimmy Butler maybe just going to go to who offers the most money? Possibly. Maybe all it would take for Jimmy Butler's Rob Pelinka, but there's a lot of teams that can offer Jimmy Butler the same money that the Lakers can, and Jimmy Butler's not as good as Kyrie Irving, at least in my eyes. The only person the Lakers currently employ that we know is even good at their job, much less great, is LeBron James. They need to utilize him when they are trying to get another person who is good at what they do.
And I do believe, like you, if LeBron James, whatever he's going to tell that player in free agency, he needs to be able to tell the press about Frank Vogel right now. Because if Vogel is selected the head coach in a normal process, I'm cool with it. I'm cool with his basketball. But LeBron James has got to take a speaking part. We can't allow all these other things to continue to go on. They got incompetent people doing incompetent things, and it continues. Like, it's going to get worse. LeBron, man, this free agency is not going to go well for the Lakers. I mean, look at the big-time free agents. They don't even have a chance. They're not even going to get in the room. Kevin Durant is not even taking a phone call, even though they might not have his number, like Broussard and everything. But, I mean, if you look at that, KD, Kawhi, Klay, no chance. And they're the LA Lakers.
And even if LeBron didn't do it yesterday or the day before with Frank Vogel, at some point when he talks about the coach, he's got to throw his full-throated support behind it. Because if there's disrepair in there early in the season, if this narrative continues, it's going to submarine the entire season.
Good times for the Lakers. Chris, stick around.
Jenna, you like this.
I love it. I love it. Is Steph back in the conversation for the best player in the world? That's next on First Things First.
And we're going to talk on that Broussard thing, because that was dirty fool by Kevin Durant. I know what Broussard was talking about. I know what Kevin Durant tried to do. That was...